The core quadrants of Daniel Offman will help you to deal with annoying customers or people in your team. It's an amazing tool or way of you to give you more insight in yourself and in other people. With these core qualities or the core quadrants, we get an interesting view on how relationships work. And if this interests you, make sure to keep watching and stay tuned. I'm Carolina Sherman and welcome to my channel where I share videos to help you and other online business owners to speed process your growth by doing the internal work first. So let's talk about this concept of the core quadrants that's invented by Daniel Offman. You have four quadrants. Well, four, that's what quadrants means, no? Well, we have four parts that give you inside information about your personality and how you form your relationships with other people. It starts with your own core qualities. Everybody is born with some core qualities. Good qualities that come naturally to you. You are born with them. Your strengths, things that flourish in you naturally, like you might be naturally determined or consistent, or you might be naturally fearless, or you might be naturally persuasive. But our good qualities will at the same time also trigger our pitfalls. When we go in overdrive on that quality and are being too determined, then we get pushy, or too consistent and we get rigid, or too patient and we get passive, or too persuasive and we get manipulative, or too fearless and we become reckless. You get it? That's a pitfall. You've probably heard this before when someone said to you, "Ah, don't be so." That's when you go in overdrive on your good quality. Don't be so this or that. Well, that's your pitfall. And then you can start to think, okay, what is this too much of? Because a pitfall is always the result of too much of your good quality. If you find it difficult to come up with them, then just check out what other people might find irritating on you and then you can reverse engineer it. And then we have yet another quadrant, the third quadrant, and that's your challenge. A challenge is also a good quality, but it's a quality you might not naturally possess. It's the opposite of your pitfall, like the opposite of reckless is careful or cautious, or the opposite of pushy is patient, or the opposite of manipulative is genuine or sincere or openness or understanding. Or the opposite of rigid is flexible. And this will become your challenge to incorporate this quality that you don't have, but complements your core quality perfectly into your life. It will be your challenge to focus in on that quality, to try to live more by that quality that in fact doesn't come all that natural to you. And if you can find your balance between your core quality and your challenge, then you are being very, very effective. Then you can be patiently determined, or carefully fearless, or sincere and persuasive, or flexibly consistent, or consistent but flexible, you know. Then you also have your pitfall under control. Your challenge will keep you, your core quality in balance so that you don't go in overdrive. And did you know that we often attract people who have those challenges of us as a core quality and people who therefore complement us and seem like the perfect match? Like your partner or your best friend, they might have this extremely awesome other quality that you don't have and that complements you so well. Yeah, right? Everyone has this. But the danger in this is when that person goes in overdrive with their core quality, with your challenge, then their pitfall becomes your allergy. So if you are determined, you can't stand too much of patience, or that will end up in passiveness. If you are consistent, then you can't stand too much of flexibility. That might end up in wobbliness, you know? So this is where conflicts between people can arise. This is why relationships are not always as easy. And that's why there is a beauty in recognizing these patterns. Because from the moment that you know about these core qualities, these quadrants, these pitfalls, these challenges, and these allergies, then we can look for the beauty in every person. You can look for the other core qualities in people that you might admire and that might be your challenge. You can acknowledge that you have pitfalls that are other people's allergies, and that therefore it's natural that other people have pitfalls too that might be your allergy and that you can't stand. As much as you might be irritated by this person's pitfall and only see the differences between the two of you, it might be amazing if you were able to see that that person is as human as you are. Wouldn't you want people to have patience with you when you go in overdrive with your core quality? To see it for what it is? Because a pitfall is just only too much of something so beautiful. So if you look at the beauty of it, you can get an immediate calmness that comes over you. Last week we talked about how to deal with people who suck your energy, energy vampires. It was all about how to deal with people who frustrate you. Well, this part might perfectly connect to your new way of looking at people. Why do people frustrate you? Well, it's always a mirror. That person is going in overdrive on a quality that you don't have and that would suit you well. If that person could give some of their overdrive to you, and if you could give some of your overdrive to them, then there would be perfect balance. So that's why I love to get these insights. It brings us closer together if we can see it right, if we can just be open to it, you know, and we can see that we are not all that different. We all have pitfalls, and we all have allergies, and we all have challenges that can learn us something about ourselves. These concepts make me able to get more insight about myself and why we react the way we react to certain people. What are your core qualities? Tell me in the comments down below. Mine are ambition, curious, dependable, direct, enthusiastic, responsible, independent, and optimistic. It feels so good to look for your core qualities. It's like giving yourself compliments. You should try it. Underneath this video, I've got a list you can download with all different sorts of qualities. And let me know what your qualities are. I'm very, very curious. And listen, if you feel that you owe it to yourself to give yourself all the tools that you need to grow to the highest level of your potential, and yes, that is unlimited, then make your mark by subscribing to this channel and liking this video. And I will guide you to speed process your growth for direct outer success. And don't forget to leave a comment so we can connect. And I'll see you in another video. Keep watching.